For more than a year now, across thousands of miles in all 50 states, tens of millions of Americans have made their voices heard. Today, I just want to add mine. I want to congratulate Hillary Clinton on making history as the presumptive Democratic nominee for President of the United States. Look, I know how hard this job can be. That's why I know Hillary will be so good at it. In fact, I don't think there's ever been someone so qualified to hold this office.
Secretary of Defense Robert Gates states that it's almost a certainty foreign nations like China and Iran and Russia hacked into her server. Why is it beyond any logical reasoning to assume a terrorist organization also could have hacked into her private server that was unencrypted for 3 months? She used a private server that was unencrypted for 3 months.
She's got the courage.
I remember landing under sniper fire. There was supposed to be some kind of a greeting ceremony at the airport, but instead we just ran with our heads down to get into the vehicles.
The compassion.
Well, can I talk and then maybe you can listen to what I say? Okay, thank you very much.
And the heart to get the job done.
She's lying. She's absolutely lying. She told me something entirely different at the casket ceremony. She said it was the cause of the video, and that she would get back to me and tell me what happened with my son. She has not only not gotten back to me, but all I've ever heard is that I am not to know because I'm not a member of the immediate family.
And I say that as somebody who had to debate her more than 20 times.
While I was working on those streets, watching those folks see their jobs shipped overseas, you were a corporate lawyer sitting on the board of Walmart.
Even after our own hard-fought campaign.
Hillary Clinton, she'll say anything and change nothing.
In a testament to her character,
Hillary Clinton will say anything to get elected.
She agreed to serve our country as Secretary of State. And from the decision we made in the Situation Room to get Bin Laden, to our pursuit of diplomacy in capitals around the world, I have seen her judgment.
I made a mistake, plain and simple.
I have seen her judgment.
Did you make a mistake?
I did.
I've seen her toughness. I've seen her commitment to our values up close. I've seen her determination to give every American a fair shot at opportunity, no matter how tough the fight was.
Not just gangs of kids anymore. They are often the kinds of kids that are called super predators. No conscience, no empathy. We can talk about why they ended up that way, but first we have to bring them to heel.
That's what's always driven her, and it still does. So I want those of you who've been with me from the beginning of this incredible journey to be the first to know that I'm with her. I am fired up, and I cannot wait to get out there and campaign for Hillary. I also want to thank everybody who turned out to vote.
Tens of thousands of voters found their names had been removed from the roll.
Voters have had to wait up to 5 hours in line.
The polling closed at 7 o'clock. They were still in line at midnight.
125,000 voters were purged from the polls in one of New York City's five boroughs alone.
Just 60 polling places were open. That's down from 200 in 2012.
18,000 registered voters were forced to come to one location.
And who worked so hard for our candidates.
Polling staffs were unable to operate voting machines, gave out conflicting information, and erroneously directed voters to alternate sites.
Some people reportedly even had to miss work because of it.
Think of all the employers that allowed people to take time off so they could vote.
Polling stations that failed to open on time and poll workers who were unable to tell voters when they would be operational.
Notoriously incompetent.
Oh, the incompetence is breathtaking.
Who's to blame for this, these long lines?
Well, the voters for getting in line.
She's blaming the voters for going to vote in a democracy.
This is not how democracy is supposed to work.
This has been a hard-fought race.
It's supposed to be easy to vote, not hard.
I know some say these primaries have somehow left the Democratic Party more divided.
CNN, in their report, used the word violence. Debbie Wasserman Schultz used the word violence.
Violence and intimidation are never acceptable under any circumstances.
There were no arrests. No one was sent to the hospital. Was it accurate reporting by CNN to say that there was violence?
There was no violence.
That is a big
stuff
difference.
Was thrown as well.
What chair? What video? Did you see the video of a chair thrown?
That's
what
those was thrown? The reports from the floor.
There's a videotape of a guy picking up a chair.
Not only did he not throw the chair, they hugged him afterwards.
Her campaign and her super PAC are pulling down Facebook groups of her opponent that she's running against.
So once you pay people $1 million to attack the other side online,
they would post pornography, child pornography.
Guess what they do? They attack the other side online.
Well, you know, they said that 8 years ago as well. But just like 8 years ago, there are millions of Americans, not just Democrats, who've cast their ballots for the very first time.
People couldn't even find the end of the line. There was a lack of guidance.
North Carolina removed same-day registration when they saw that a lot of the people using it were African Americans, minorities.
Addition of photo ID being required. There have been changes to registration laws.
The voting machines were rigged in Chicago.
They were erasing votes.
What they're describing,
they had to literally erase Bernie Sanders' votes,
is election fraud.
And add Hillary Clinton.
This is how corporate tyranny works.
There are millions of Americans, not just Democrats, who've cast their ballots for the very first time. And a lot of that is thanks to Senator Bernie Sanders, who has run an incredible campaign. I had a great meeting with him this week, and I thanked him for shining a spotlight on issues like economic inequality and the outsized influence of money in our politics, and bringing young people into the process. Embracing that message is going to help us win in November, but more importantly, it'll make the Democratic Party stronger, and it will make America stronger. Secretary Clinton and Senator Sanders may have been rivals during this primary, but they're both patriots who love this country, and they share a vision for the America that we all believe in. An America that's hopeful, an America that's big-hearted, an America that is strong and fair and gives every child the same chance that we had. Those are the values that unite us as Democrats. Those are the values that make America great. Those are the values that are going to be tested in this election. And if we all come together in common effort, I'm convinced we won't just win in November. We'll build on the progress that we've made, and we will win a brighter future for this country that we love.
They asked me what I do, and I said, I'm going to bomb the shit out of them. It's true. I don't care.
We came, we saw, he died.
Did it have anything to do with your visit?